HS2 is Britain's new high-speed railway, connecting London to the West Midlands and beyond. It's the first new intercity railway north of London in over 100 years, and a transformative project for the nation's future. I'm James, Head of Delivery for Sibbles at HS2 Limited. For the past 3 years, our team have been hard at work constructing the 8.4-mile long Northolt Tunnel. Four giant tunnel boring machines, or TBMs, are building the tunnel, which is split into two sections, Northolt Tunnels West and Northolt Tunnels East. The two sections connect at Green Parkway in Greenford, where each machine will finish its drive in two giant shafts. Once complete, this tunnel will carry HS2's brand new high-speed trains around 20 metres below our capital, seamlessly linking London to Birmingham, Manchester and the North. Let's dive into the exciting progress we've made so far on the Northolt Tunnels. The Northolt Tunnel has been constructed using four state-of-the-art TBMs. Two of these machines, which were named Sushila and Caroline, were launched in late 2022 from our West Ruislip portal site where I am today. And these are to excavate the western section of the tunnel. In December, Sushila completed their journey and broke through into the Green Parkway vent shaft in Ealing. Caroline has now joined her at the same point, marking the completion of the 5-mile twin bore tunnels. Both machines will now be dismantled and carefully lifted out of the ground at Green Parkway. The eastern section of the Northolt Tunnel is also progressing at pace. Two more tunnel boring machines, Emily and Anne, were launched from our Victoria Road site in early 2024. These machines will construct an additional 3.4 miles of twin bore tunnels beneath Ealing to the Green Parkway vent shaft. Further sections of tunnels are excavated with spray concrete lining methods. All four of our machines are specifically engineered to tackle the geology beneath London, which includes layers of Lambeth Group, chalk and London clay. Each TBM weighs over 2,000 tonnes, and that's equivalent to around 500 elephants each. And they stretch for 160 metres in length. Emily and Anne will complete their tunnelling this summer, adding to the substantial progress made on this section of the project. As our tunnelling work is coming to an end, we're moving into the fit-out stage. This involves preparing the tunnels for the following installation of track and rail systems by the recently awarded rail systems contracts.
Together, our four TBMs are building the Northolt Tunnels, and currently they've excavated an incredible nearly 2 million tonnes of earth. We're committed to using this material sustainably. Around the West Ruislip portal, excavated material is being repurposed on site, helping us blend in the Cockthorpe Green Tunnel and remodelling the local landscapes. London clay from the Victoria Road site is being transported via conveyors to our London logistics hub. From there, it's being taken by rail to reuse on sites across the UK, supporting housing development, creating wildlife habitats, and restoring quarries. Inside the tunnels, we're also constructing cross passages using a ground freezing technique. These are safety links spaced every 500 metres to connect the two running tunnels to provide a secure evacuation route. And so far, we've completed 10 of the 34 cross passages. Green Parkway is at the heart of our construction of the Northolt Tunnels. And that's why we're here today. This site marks the end point for all four tunnel boring machines. When the machines arrive, they break through into specially designed reception chambers filled with foam concrete and manage the site's high water groundwater pressure, ensuring the safe and efficient TBM extraction. Once the chamber's depressurized, the ceiling can will be removed in sections with a 750-ton crane. After removing the top of the ceiling can, the TBM shield and cutter head, weighing 880 tons, will be removed with a custom-designed gantry crane. We're also making progress across the five ventilation and emergency access shafts, located at approximately 1.8-mile intervals along the Northolt Tunnels at Victoria Road, Westgate, Green Parkway here, Mandeville Road and South Ruislip. Each of these shafts will be topped with a headhouse, which is designed to complement the surrounding landscape. Once tunnelling is complete, work will begin on the West Ruislip porous portal. It's a reinforced concrete portal, which will be constructed to connect the tunnel to the overground structures. The portal is designed with roof openings or pores that prevent adverse noise being created when the HS2 trains exit the and the tunnel's enclosed environment. We're also hard at work preparing to launch our next two TBMs, which will build the Euston Tunnels, taking HS2 into the heart of the capital.
With HS2, we're creating a railway for generations to come, which will transform how we use the current rail network. We're creating capacity, and it will transform local services and provide faster, low-carbon journeys between London, Birmingham and beyond. Our investment in rail infrastructure is already fueling regional economic growth, immediate opportunities for development, employment and local businesses. Prime example of this is the transformative Elizabeth Line, which has now surpassed 500 million passenger journeys since it opened in 2022. And its popularity really highlights the vital role in London and the UK's transport network. Thank you for watching this update. We're making great progress on the Northolt Tunnel, and there's much more to come as we deliver Britain's new high-speed future.